Do you like to eat bitter things? If yes, then comment below why do you like. Most of the people will be disturbed by thinking of bitter food items. Why? Let's check it out. Hello friends, here I have Doodle with me and welcome to Scientific Alley. Today I am giving you something special. Ta-da! Chicken! Hey! 30 minutes later. What happened, Doodle? Oh my god. Actually, I had added too much spices, so Doodle isn't. In this situation, I had asked him for water. And he was angry at me. Why? Is it true that taste really can change our moods? And also how mood can change our taste for food? I would like to start with how do we taste food items. We know that our tongue functions for it, but actually the small bumps on our tongue perform this job. If you look at your tongue in the mirror, you can see it's covered in little bumps. And in those bumps are taste buds. When you put something in your mouth, they send a message to your brain to give you information about food. Your sense of smell helps to taste the flavor of food too. When you're chewing food, chemicals are released that travel up to your nose. Your nose then tells your brain how food tastes and how it smells. That's why when you have a cold, you can't taste things. Try holding your nose when you eat something. It's hard to taste the exact flavor, isn't it? Try it at home and comment your experience. Can you become angry while eating a chocolate? It's rare, right? But if you are chewing a chili pepper in your mouth, you can be angry, yeah? Similarly, while eating a bitter gourd, you will be probably having a little hating mood. And sour taste makes you little moody. This can be said by not only me, but researchers also prove that taste and mood has a link between each other. So it's said that before meeting your boss, you should offer him a piece of chocolate so that he will be in a happy mood. I would like to present you a story right now. For 2 weeks in the spring of 2009, North Dakota State University shut down so that students could help place millions of sandbags along the Red River to prevent disastrous flooding during an especially wet season. Once the danger had subsided, psychologists saw a research opportunity. They asked more than 100 students how likely they were to help down the sandbags. Those who liked sweet foods most, the researchers reported last year in the Journal of Personality and Social Psychology were most likely to offer help, not just with the sandbags but also with an unrelated study for an English prof. The people who drink a bitter tasting herbal supplement offered harsh judgment about things such as like a library book stealing student or man eating his own already dead dog. Really awkward, yeah? The people who drank sweet berry punch or water were of positive attitude. A German study published last summer involving people with high depression and anxiety found that those experiencing intense emotions, suppose watching happy or sad videos, they tasted bitter, sweet and sour foods more strongly. But when we stress, we can taste sweet more strongly. Hence, it is clear that there is a link between the taste and our mood. And you should never cry when you are sitting for eating food, because food is essential for healthy body as well as healthy mood. Okay, thanks friends for watching this video, and for such more videos, stay tuned with Scientific Health. If you like this video, press the like button. For more such scientific videos, subscribe and press the bell button.